Here's something that's not going to keep going.
Yeah.
That is the Toronto Raptors.
LeBronto!
Oh, come on, man. You're giving in to that mainstream bullshit that we have to hear today.
Hey, I like Mark Jones. That was pretty creative, I thought.
But it wasn't Mark Jones who thought of it.
I thought it was Mark Jones. Who said it first? Was it Ray J? Some of y'all got it, some of y'all didn't. Okay. Who said it? I'm pretty sure. Who needs LeBron James? That's not LeBron toe. That's not Skip Bayless didn't say LeBron toe first.
He did.
No, it was Mark Jones
give that dude credit because I don't like him.
He said
it prior to that game.
Did he?
Yes.
He said LeBron toe.
Yes.
Oh, okay. So
I thought if he says it, it should automatically be put to bed. That's my thoughts with everything Skip Bayless said.
They got t-shirts and artwork. And
I like Mark Jones.
Mark Jones.
Who?
Mark Jones.
I love him. I don't like that guy from Fox Sports 1. So here's what I don't understand.
Tell me.
Moving on from Dwayne Casey, a gamble Raptors might have to make. Firing Casey seems deeply unfair. If the measure is the quality of the person, there isn't a more liked or respected person. If Casey stays, it's a risk. If he's fired and the next head coach can't make a 59-win team better, it could blow up on Masai Ujiri, the GM. That's true. But it's a gamble that might have to be made. On top of that, you look at the contracts. There is DeRozan.
That's the problem right there.
There is Lowry. Everyone else pretty indispensable. Do you blow up the Toronto Raptors knowing three straight years they can't get past Mountain LeBron?
How's Powell getting all that money? Never mind.
Who?
Powell down there with the...
Who?
Powell with the $9 million, $10 million, $10 million.
Good agent.
Man, okay. That's good stuff from him. Anyway, yeah. Unless LeBron leaves the actual conference.
That's the question.
It doesn't matter. Yeah. It really doesn't matter. We've talked about this literally from the time that I've met you. That as long as LeBron is in the East, it doesn't matter who the teammates are, doesn't matter who the coach is, doesn't matter how bad they look in the regular season, doesn't matter how bad they look in one game. In the end, LeBron ends up in the finals every single year. It's at this point, I think this was kind of the last straw. I think people say, hey man, Toronto, number one seed, almost 60 wins. They're better than the Pacers. They got more talent, at least, than the Pacers.
But they didn't match up as well as the Pacers.
I think that was more mental. Like they would let
That's also the narrative today.
No.
They had Thaddeus Young and Miles Turner and Victor Oladipo and Lance Stevenson.
A team shoot 64% from the field for an entire game.
You do know that they have nobody who could guard Kevin Love and LeBron James.
Pascal Siakam. Don't make excuses for them now.
I'm not making excuses. I'm calling spade a spade.
So did you think they were going to get swept before?
Of course not.
They have no heart. No heart. They should go. They should leave Toronto.
Disagree.
Toronto doesn't deserve
this. So what do you do if you're the Raptors? Do you just like hang on and be like, hey man, we got 5 more years till it opens up?
You wait till LeBron leaves?
I don't think they should fire
Dwayne Casey because I
agree with that as well.
It's better than some of its parts, and I think he is a good coach, but I don't think there was anything anybody could do.
Lowry, DeRozan, what do you do?
I like Lowry. DeRozan.
He can learn from it. I say keep them together if you just want to be patient for at least 3 years. At least 3 years. Because then LeBron's 36, maybe slows. Seriously. Like you're laughing, but I'm being serious.
Lowry look like a Jalen Ramsey?
YouTube.com/TYT Sports.